on the next episode of Mix Rated.
Welcome to Mix Rated. So there's been a lot of speculation on the internet about a recent announcement we made on our Facebook page. To fill you guys in, we announced that as of this episode, a key fixture of the Mix Rated cast will no longer be a part of the show. With that said, it is my unfortunate duty to let you guys know that Olivia's cast is off!
We have a show to get on with. Okay, you guys, I'm here. The cast is off.
Show them your cast.
Hello.
Oh, let me smell it.
No, please. It smells like skin and lotion.
Yeah.
Look, we're sorry to have fooled you guys, and I appreciate all of your messages, your tweets, and concerns, but I'm here to stay, and sadly, the cast is no more. But I can wash both hands now.
Yeah. I must say, it's bittersweet, because the cast has been with us since the beginning. Yeah. So let's take a brief moment to bid our departing cast member a final adieu.
Bad.
I'm not crying. I just got pink eye.
Oh, really? Gross. Anyways, we've got a show to run here, okay? Compose yourself. On today's show, I catch up with a hip-hop group that you guys have probably never heard of before. Some guys called the Far East Movement.
Yeah! What? You never heard the Far East Movement?
What?
That's my favorite restaurant. Obviously, I love those guys. While you're doing that, I get to get my geek on by giving you an inside look at the Nintendo 3DS, you guys. Ooh.
Jealous. And the guys from Beta State come into the Mix Rated studio to rock out. Yeah. But first, we take you guys on a trip.
Yeah, that's right. Olivia dragged me to WonderCon this past weekend where we interviewed grown adults just like overweight Spidey. You can't swing from above your 300 pounds.
That you cannot do. I mean, it was pretty cool to see people come out the cosplay closet. But honestly, I felt like we were on Planet Nerd.
Yes.
And for that, we knew we could not miss this one. So here it is. Check it out. We are here live at the 25th anniversary of WonderCon. Now, Joey is a WonderCon virgin.
Yes, I am a virgin. I'm a virgin of WonderCon!
Speaking of virgins, Joey, you know that a lot of virgins converge at WonderCon every year.
You mean I'm gonna get de-virginized here?
You're gonna get de-virginized here at WonderCon.
We'll pick someone.
By a geek, a nerd, a cosplayer, maybe even in the act of LARPing.
Hey, I'm in the mood for LARPing. I don't even know what it means, but it sounds sexy.
All right, you guys, so come with us. We're gonna check out what is going down this year at WonderCon. Ready?
Let's go.
Let's go. Is this like the excuse to just like go topless?
Yeah, feel sexy for a bit.
What's your best E Honda move?
I gotta give you a 10 for the spinal disconnect on that one. How are the vertebrae going right now?
They're actually kind of numb. Feels good though.
All right, oh, you're gonna get all the girls with that move today. I can feel it.
Sweet.
Why are you cleaning your boys dirty?
This is a sand trooper.
Sand trooper. I thought he needed some Febreze or something. Keep it clean. Oh, do it again. Watch this. Swag trooper. Swag trooper. There's a guy trying to get Batman and Spider-Man's number. Show the muscles. Watch this, you guys. Show the muscles. Look at the cuts on this. Do that for the ladies right there. There you go, brother.
All this was thrown together last minute.
Oh, he just built this. That's great. He put duct tape on his shoulder and got his auntie's wig. That's nice. I don't speak Spanish. Here's to you, Olivia.
Now, I know nothing about the Marx Brothers. Maybe our viewers don't either. Can you give us a little rundown? Who are the Marx Brothers?
A genius comedic group from what era was it again?
Oh, you don't know either.
My mom made me dress like this.
Okay, I thought so. All right. How about you? I knew it was going to happen. Why is it only a horn? I should have known. Now, where does this go?
Wherever you want it to.
Ooh, exciting. Is it a real syringe?
It's a straw.
It's a straw. Yeah, you can't see. You just broke character.
I mean, it's a syringe.
You can't break character.
I'm not.
All right, straighten up. Come on. And you have to be more conviction in the voice.
Okay.
Olivia, what do you want?
Olivia, do what you want.
See, no, breaking character again. Now, just for reference here, before we even started the camera, what did you just say?
I said I need antihistamines due to a coarse throat, and I have this extreme mucus going through my nose, my nasal passage.
Well, you know, I don't even know. I don't know what else to say. See what kind of shenanigans Joey is getting to on the other side of WonderCon.
You see how they treat Asians? You see how they treat the Asians here? Look where the gun is pointing, first of all. This guy means business. Show me one move for the ladies. Go for it. Oh, constipation. Oh, come fly with me to Castro. Do a bow right there.
I told you, no fighting.
Dun, dun, dun. These boots were made for walking rough. Say something for the ladies.
Hello, ladies.
Can you do one move for the camera? I'll be so excited. Ooh! That's a bougie style. Where's your weapon?
Oh, right here.
Ooh, what? Oh, Lord. Spank me. Go ahead. Spank me. I think you're one of the prettiest ladies I've seen in no lie.
Oh, you're very good.
And what does this mean?
It means come hither, sweetie darling.
Can you guys do some LARPing right now for us? I gotta say, so the last time I was at a sex club, everyone was wearing gas masks.
Sex club later, I guess.
Okay, now how are you gonna incorporate the horn and the gas mask?
Just really horny. Sorry, little horn.
Come on, give me a better one than that. Are you seeing a lot of geeks, a lot of virgins here today?
Yes, I'm a virgin.
See, we have one in our grasp. What do your girlfriends think about this whole thing? Or do you have girlfriends? That's the magic question.
She's involved too. She loves it. She does it too.
Is it an online girlfriend? Come on, be real.
No. A real, like, real life, actual girlfriend.
Tangible? You can touch her?
Yes.
Do you often? Wow, there's consent. It's a consensual relationship. Well, kudos to you, Ken.
Thank you.
Okay, which one of you knows best how to please a woman?
I do.
That was very confident. All right, what's the secret? Another lie. Listening.
Dang.
See, that's how I know that you're a true nerd. All right, that's going to do it for us. us here at WonderCon, the 25th anniversary. Joey, I'm so glad you got to come today.
I had fun. I almost cried because we had to leave. Seriously, thank you for bringing me.
I know, of course. And Joey has been officially de-virginized.
Yeah.
Welcome to the club, Joey.
And it hurt, girl. It hurt.
Well, you know what? It hurt good. That's all I can say. What's your favorite part of WonderCon?
You know what? Wonder Woman was Chinese, and that's cool because I'm Asian.
That's cool. I actually met a guy.
You did?
Yeah, the guy in the green suit.
No.
I gave my number.
You're lying.
I am.
With no underwear.
All right, we're going to kick it to you guys in the studio. You two very good-looking people. Who might they be?
They might be Joey and Olivia.
That's right. That's us.
You're so beautiful.
Here they are in the studio, guys.
Gracias for the compliment. You guys aren't so bad yourself.
All right, stick around. We've got an interview with the Far East Movement when we return.
As well. Welcome back to Mixed Rated. So Olivia,
yes.
You got to interview the Far East Movement.
That's right, I did.
Yeah. Who do you think was the best looking?
Oh, God, Joey, that's such an easy one. It was for sure the Asian guy. Duh.
I'm Asian.
Check it out. Now, you guys are no stranger to Mix. We worked with you guys several times before.
What's up, y'all? Mix, we are the Far East Movement FM in the house. Where we going, we don't need roads. And where we stop, nobody knows.
No. To the stars, if you really want it. Got a jet pack with. Now, you guys have been around since 2003. Would you say it's been an easy road to get to where you are now?
It's the road that we took. I mean, in the end, this is what we love to do. Every day we wake up in the morning, we just want to write music, or we want to perform, or, you know, we want to get on the internet and chat with some people, get on Facebook and get on Twitter, check out some people over there, maybe flip on Mix TV and watch a music video. We love this. We're fans of music, you know, and fans number one. In the end, we love what we're doing. So 7 years, it seems like it's only been 3 days. Like a G6, chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kick. Girl, you always on my mind, got my head up in the sky, and I'm never looking down, feeling priceless. Yeah. I can't go anywhere without hearing Like a G6. Like a G6. I go to Vegas, I go to San Francisco, LA, the song plays in every club at least once to twice a night. Now, did you guys expect for that song to have propelled to the status that it did? Is it a little bit surreal? Actually, you know, it's funny, when we actually recorded that song in the back of a pool house, you know, with the homies, and you know, we got a little bit slizzard. When we left, we put it on the net, we put on a little mixtape, we went on tour, came back, and in 3 months, we hit like a million hits on YouTube. Actually, Merman, though, at the same time, was saying that was a hit, but we didn't listen to him.
What can I say?
We just got to thank the people that are helping us out, you know, and the people that are supporting the record, because, I mean, it hit the top 10 on iTunes, and that was something that we never thought would ever happen.
We have a great array of music. We have a bunch of features, great features. We actually have Snoop Dogg on the album.
Is he just doing anything?
And he's not even just rapping, he's actually singing. Let you wake up in the morning and you kiss yourself. We got him to get into our lane, so he's singing, keeping it real funky. We actually have the beautiful Keri Hilson on the album. You ain't a dime, use a silver dollar. It'd be a crime if I didn't. Production done by the Stereotypes, Roger Sanchez, Cherry Cherry Boom Boom, Fernando Garibay, so should be a fun album. I like girls that like me, so you
and me and her can have a fun menage a three. We really wanted to take pop, hip hop, you know, electro, dance, and anything that inspired us and fuse it into one sound. So when you hear it, some people that think of Far East Movement think
they're going to either expect a dance album or a hip hop album. And, you know, we really want to let the listeners know, you know, we worked hard to really craft a new sound of everything that we're fans of and give layers to the Far East movement, the Free Wire lifestyle. I must add that Bruno Mars is also a writer on the album too.
Yeah, it's the Bruno Mars.
I see you, you see me, I see her too, let's be three. Don't hate, you could all get some.
Now you guys are signed right now to Cherry Tree Records.
Cherry Tree Interscope. We used to intern there, which is crazy, and we would literally get lunch for 50 Cent, you know, watch Black Eyed Peas walk by, Maya, Gwen Stefani, whoever. So to be there as an artist kind of trips us out, where we now have access to rooms that we didn't have access to before. They invited us to Jimmy Iovine's house. When we were at his house, he's like, yeah, let's watch a movie. It was him, Will.i.am, and Quincy Jones, and us, and of course, Martin Kirzenbaum, and that's it. So we're like, we're with like the greatest in the music business, and just us, and we watched Inglourious Basterds. After that, he's like, so, you guys want to join the family? Yes.
So. I already signed mine during the movie. Yeah. I signed the contract during the movie.
So it was a great feeling, and it was something that we'll never forget. And they're an incredible label that we look forward to building with.
Now, I ain't never been to space before, but I ain't never seen a face like yours. You make me feel like I could touch the planets. You want the moon, girl, watch me grab it.
All right, well, thank you guys so much for joining us. And
no doubt. No, thank you.
I'm sure we'll see you guys again. Let's fly.
Here we go. Come
Wait, Joey. You know who sings that song?
Barbie's Movement.
That's right. Let's keep it that way. You know, I love the way that they dress. It's so planetary.
You like their gear?
I do.
They must shop at Ross on Neptune. I just said, don't beat me up. That's four of you. So you know what? You don't have to be tall to get the ladies, right? Just like them. I'm 5'6", and I have two imaginary ex-girlfriends.
Yeah, you do.
Shaquisha. Larissa.
And Joey gets even weirder. All right, now don't you dare go anywhere. Mix Rated is going to be right back with a brand new Nintendo 3DS. And Beta State gets undiscovered. Don't go anywhere, you guys.
Felicia!
Felicia! Felicia!
No hickeys. Hey, welcome back to Mix Rated, y'all. While Olivia's ready to chop it up with Beta State, I'm about to be joined by Mix Rated tech affiliate Radford Castro in a new segment we call Technically Awesome. I'd like to introduce you to my good friend from LazyTechGuys.com, Radford Castro. Give it up, you guys. Come on. When I say Radford, you say Castro. I like that name. It's powerful. You don't say I'm Radford from Castro. I'm just kidding. Yo, so what do you got in your hand, Mr. Cool Guy?
We have here the 3DS from Nintendo. It's the latest portable.
Yes! Yes!
And there's a lot of things right now that have been added onto it from the last one. You know, all of the good stuff like the dual screens, the voice, touchpad.
Do I need glasses?
Nope.
No, you do glasses. Not. I don't need glasses to look at your thing. No?
No, you do not. Okay. All it requires is this little slider here that actually changes it from 2D to 3D, and it does just like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. It's pretty cool. I've seen dual screens and the touch and the whole voice, but what's different about this?
One of the things that people haven't talked too much about is the augmented reality. So the augmented reality is actually using the actual backgrounds of wherever you're shooting with the camera. And then actually playing games like a shooting game where you can actually take a photograph of someone and put them in the game itself and actually shoot the people in the game. And they call that game Face Raiders, so you can actually, you know, take a picture of something, or actually it's live, so you're actually taking shots of the game. And
so it doesn't have to be my face.
Yeah.
It could be my penis. Well, it's big, you need a bigger screen.
It fits just right, actually.
This is because I'm Asian? So tell me, what are the bad things about this game?
Well, the 3D, for fighting games, it's a little bit tougher, because when you're playing, some people play like this. There's a certain area where you have to look at the 3D, right? So when you look at it in a certain spot and you're playing where you might shift it a little bit, the 3D might disappear for a bit, or it might look a little garbled or weird. There are some games that are more 3D that are better for 3D, like racing games and flying games, and then those are probably best on this kind of device. So,
what are the good things about this?
The good things? Well, obviously, aside from the 3D and the AR games, they have an analog control now. So you can actually control the game a little bit more cleaner. An SD card here, so you can actually put, you know, pictures and stuff.
Nice.
They have this new thing called Street Pass, where you can actually play the games with it inside your pocket. Like a Street Fighter, if you're gonna play Street Pass, you can actually have it closed and play against people with the game closed. So it's actually pretty cool. The other cool thing, there's gonna be software that you can download onto it, so you can play games you can download from online, so that's
okay,
cool
great.
Too.
How much is this damn thing?
$249.
Yeah. Now, Red, where can we find more about you guys?
You can find more about us at lasertechguys.com.
Let's go ahead and check in with my girl, Olivia, who's chatting it up with our undiscovered act, Beta State.
With catchy rock riffs and uplifting lyrics, Beta State's story proves to be just as empowering as the music they play.
How did you guys find each other? How did you get together?
Adrian and I and Justin started jamming around about 2 years ago, and we're looking for a singer, and we started doing these online auditions. We got a bunch of submissions and stuff, and both of you there after we found Maddie.
Now, how would you describe your music? Like, what is Beta State?
Just music that we all feel. I mean, it's a collaboration of all of our emotions and feelings, and just, you know, how we're feeling with life and comes out in music, really.
Once Matt joined, we had already had a bunch of instrumentals, so it was a lot easier to kind of start writing right off the bat.
The day I show up, they pop 55 instrumentals on my lap and say, write what you want to write. When we will go into the studio and start writing a song or come up with an idea that the song begins with, we never talk about, well, we want it to be this pace or this sound, or it's just, how am I feeling today?
So you guys sort of have an upbeat feel to your music. There's a lot of positivity in the lyrics. But where does that come from?
I always know that no matter how bad things get, there's always that light at the end of the tunnel.
The one thing that really struck me on the album is this elephant with the wings.
It's actually a design that a friend of ours drew up. It kind of just stuck with us, so we decided to run with it, and I think it kind of defines who we are, like trying to be better than good enough.
Okay, so they have positive lyrics and a cool flying elephant as a mascot. But what is the story behind Beta State's name?
The Beta State is resonated to us because sounding good, and it also means that you're living. That means like we're all right now in our beta state and we're just in the moment, and we thought that was really fitting for the band because we're not really dwelling on the past. We're looking on like a bright future and just kind of living for the now.
I feel it! Why? Guess what? Here to perform their hit song, I'm Still Alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, Beta State.
Get you here while I'm still alive.
stop me now. This is my one chance to feel right. And don't look back tonight. And so I said, I never meant to be.
What?
Yeah, it's over.
I said no. It is not over. It is over.
It is. But you know what, you guys? You can go to our YouTube channel and watch full episodes of Mix Rated in glorious HD.
And check this out. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter to stay up on your Mix Rated game. Thank you all for watching.
Yay, everybody. Go dance.
Slow dance. Euphoria. Euphoria.
Hello. Damn.
Michelle Martinez.
Watch my corn. Damn. Watch my Michelle Martinez be tripping.